been showing us how to elevate simple hairpins into beautiful keepsakes for Valentine's Day, and really just every day of the year, if you ask me, is Orly. These are adorable.
Aren't they beautiful?
They're really nice.
They're really fun, and I think that, again, Valentine's Day comes at such a perfect time because it's right as we're getting ready for spring, and flowers are such a beautiful thing during spring. I'm featuring, obviously, a couple of hearts as well, which feel very specific to Valentine's Day. But in my hair, take a look, I've got three of the simple ones.
Oh, Orly.
And they're sort of, they're evergreen. I mean, these will be in style at any time, would be beautiful for like a brunch, an event,
they're
anything.
They're so cute.
Yeah, they're fun.
I mean, and they're for adults, for little girls.
Honestly.
My mom would wear them.
Yeah.
So cute. We can give them to my mom's salon.
Exactly.
Right, so how do we make the roses?
Okay, so what you want to do is take your felt. I'm using felt for these right now. And you want to take the straight edge. We're going to create basically this that you see right here. It's essentially a straight edge with a scalloped edge that increases in size.
Okay, so that's important.
Very important, yeah, in order to create our rose. So you're just gonna freehand it. You're gonna start off on one end and kind of curl. Then you're gonna come around.
So it doesn't have to be perfect.
No. Just keep going. Just keep an eye and make sure that you're getting slightly larger as you go. And that's really it. Once you have it, right? So I would just continue that all the way down until I have one of these. So Deb, I want you to try this too.
Do you have to use felt?
That's actually a very good question, because while felt is the easiest material, the reason that it's the easiest is because it cuts clean, so it doesn't fray.
Right. Okay.
That's number one. The other thing is it's kind of stiff enough to hold its shape with the petals. And the other is that both sides of it are identical. So when you see the outside of the petal or the inside of the petal, it looks good. Whereas like a faux leather would be really cool, but that inside is not pretty to look at.
And the silk is going to be too flimsy.
Too flimsy. Exactly.
Linen.
Yeah. Linen, although it'll fray.
Oh, linen.
Yeah,
price.
I know. Felt is really a great option and super inexpensive. Okay, so you take this one.
Okay.
And I'm actually, let me grab this hot glue gun. I'm gonna swoop it around you. So for you, you don't need to worry about gluing it. I just want you to kind of show the rolling aspect of it. And what we're gonna do is you're basically gonna pinch and roll and just keep kind of rolling and pinching. And because the petals are a tiny bit smaller and then get larger, you end up with the effect of
a rosebud.
Exactly.
Oh my
and
gosh.
As you keep going, you can start to adjust a little bit. Like if I need, let's say, this one, I want to kind of pull it in a little bit. I can add a little bit more glue, create a tiny little pleat in it, and keep going. Yeah. And what was really fun that I realized is once I was done, I was able to pull on the petals and sort of open them. So if I can show you this one right here, you can see I was able to like pull them down and open them so that the rose like opened up in a really pretty way. So you just keep wrapping, adding glue, maybe like, you know, every rotation you add a little droplet of glue. And just try to keep the bottom part fairly flat because that's what we're gonna add here to our clips. But other than that, we just keep rolling and going until you end up with this really pretty rose that sort of opens up. And if you look at it here, you can see this is then when you would start to sort of peel it open.
Sort of go cute.
Yeah, isn't it pretty though?
Yeah.
And it's one of those things, though I obviously made a bunch of them, and this is your first one, which actually is still pretty good considering.
Pretty good.
But the more you make, the better you get at it because you start to understand how tight to hold it, how much glue to add, all that good stuff. So once you have your rose, then it comes down to just adding little adornments to it if you want. So you can see over here, I added a couple crystals. This one, I added just red crystals and kind of a couple of them. And it was really funny when we were making these, a couple of people were like, these feel like something Katy Perry would wear.
Wow,
like it's
so
like retro and fun and sparkly and playful. And then you could do something like these guys over here where I mixed two different roses together and I just put a simple clean white crystal in the middle.
Really
so
cute.
Aesthetic wise, you can really have at it.
So speaking of the crystals,
my
favorite ones, I mean, I love these roses and they're really sweet and they're very nostalgic and bring me back to, you know, grade school. But the ones that are the hearts that are all of the crystals are sort of fancy.
They're really fancy. And
they're
fun. They're fun because depending on where you choose to put, so you can see like on this one here, I put the clip going in sideways. So you could put it into the side of your bun so it's coming out the side or however you're gonna do it. And they're actually very easy to do. So first thing that I did is again, I just used a stiff felt and I just cut out a heart.
All right.
Super simple. Now you're gonna take your E6000 or whatever kind of gem glue that you really like. And you want to work in sort of smaller sections because you don't want the glue to have too much time to dry before you've gotten to that next section.
Okay.
And especially with felt, it can kind of like suck in that glue.
Okay.
So the only reason I put a little glue here is because you want to get like a little tacky, like a little, it's going to get like sticky on the
backside
of a bamboo.
Pick up
Exactly. And I'm just going to pour these out. And now you use this and just pop it onto place.
And even though you're getting glue on the front of it, it's not going to affect the...
Because it's such a small amount that you actually have on the bamboo skewer that it's not going to deposit any onto your rhinestone. And if you got a little bit on the rhinestone, like it flipped upside down, right. Get rid of that rhinestone. Because you're going to end up with like a smudge
gritty.
On it. Yeah, just get rid of it. And all you do is just fill it in all the way around.
Any specific sort of gems or rhinestones?
Flat back. So flat back is super important to make sure if you get the kind that has that little pyramid in the back, it's not going to work. They're just not going to sit flat.
And then you just glue the clip or the pin on and you're done.
Yeah, exactly. You can see here, I even left it just like this for now, just so you could see. But when you're done, just add a little piece of felt to cover it.
That is really cute.
Then, yeah.
Orly.
Isn't it fun?
Could you?
Don't mind if I do.
Let's see.
Oh, wait, hold on. I want to go. Actually, it would be better on this
side. Okay, go that way.
Hold on. Hold, please.
Okay. It's like the hair salon.
Although Francine's going to be very upset with me.
It looks adorable. I love this. Make sure to visit HallmarkChannel.com for more information.